This lesson is for you if you are an expert, if you are a coach, a consultant, an author, or if you're just a business owner, which is actually most of the people who watch this webpage, you're business owners. And I'm here to make you aware of the changes you need to make as you move into the future. Everything's shifting. You've probably seen it around you. And there's a way to actually cut through all this and be smart about what you have and about what you know. That's why I call this how to dramatically increase your income forever. I'm going to show you how. Selling what you know, right? Selling what you know. So here's the deal. I want you to realize that if you are watching this training right now, then you need to realize that you have an asset, all right? So what you bring with you is an asset which is unique to you, and it's an asset that has value. And it's very likely that you aren't getting as much out of that asset as you should. And I'm going to tell you how I do it, how my students do it, and how you can do it too. So here's what I want you to think of when it comes to your asset, okay? And you may want to draw this if you can. It'll help you remember it. But think of this little funnel here. There are three things that make up your asset. And so every single person watching this, you have an asset, just like I'm explaining. The first thing that makes up your asset is your knowledge, all right? So your knowledge that you've gained up to this point is unique to you. You come from a unique background, a unique story, unique experience, right? So the knowledge is very, very important that you've gained. And you're at some level selling that knowledge in various ways, all right? The second thing that's important about your asset is your experience, all right? So making up your asset is your knowledge and your experience. But there's actually a third thing, and that is your skills. Knowledge, experience, skills. Those are the three things that make up the asset that you have. Now, the problem is that I find is that most people are not leveraging that asset. For instance, you are maybe selling that asset to an employer, all right? So they pay you a set amount and they get access to your asset, your knowledge, experience, and skills. And so you're selling it to them, right? Might be by an hourly rate, might be by a contract, but you have one customer, right? And that is severely wasting the asset, all right? If you listen to me, you are severely wasting that asset. But you may not have thought you have any options before, right? Maybe you're a coach, consultant, and maybe you sell it on an hourly rate. And again, I think you are severely wasting that asset. And there's a much better way, and most people just don't know how to do it or how to transition to it. And this is what makes up your asset. And what it means is there are literally thousands of people out there who would love to benefit from what it is you know, from your experience and from your skills, but they can't benefit from it because you don't have anything set up for them to get. That's what I mean by not leveraging the asset. There's nothing for them to get. So there's thousands of people out there who would love to benefit from what you know. And the people who are benefiting, or the person who's benefiting the least from your asset is you. And of course, right? Because you're the one who actually should be benefiting, but yet you're sitting on this asset. And we understand real estate is an asset that goes up in value and can produce cash flow. And I see your brain as the biggest asset of all, except you, like mostly every other person on this planet, severely limits themselves. They waste their asset. All right? Now, that's the argument that I have for most people, and it rings true every single time I talk to most people, as this is what's happened. All right? So if I do a little diagram here at the bottom of that graph, you can see there I've created a little lever. All right? And if we were able to push on that lever, it'd be very hard to lift the funnel, right? Because it's only a small little lever. All right? And this is the essence of levers, that if you can get a lever big enough, then you can move bigger things. All right? So if I change it to a longer lever, suddenly you can see that we have much more leverage on that funnel. Leverage on the asset, your knowledge, experience, skills. And that's effectively what you have to do if you want to increase your income forever, selling what you know. You have to increase and change how you leverage the asset. Right now you make a certain amount of income, get a certain amount of joy, a certain amount of freedom from that asset that you have. Maybe you've been to university, maybe you've just built up these awesome skills, and you're getting the returns from that asset. And if you want more, then there's a way to do it, and I'm going to show you how that all stacks up here in this special little lesson for you, right? So this phrase is something you want to write down. It's a principle that I believe in where your ability to leverage your asset directly affects the amount of freedom you have, the amount of the impact that you have, and the money that you earn. Three things: the freedom that you have, the impact you make, and the money you earn. That all comes down to your ability to leverage your asset. And some people out there are fantastic at leveraging their asset. So therefore, they run big companies, for instance, right? They have a lot of success, a lot of effectiveness. They're able to train a lot of people at once. They're able to get a lot of customers. because they know how to leverage the asset. And so if you don't know how to leverage it in a way that helps you and supports you and supports other people too, then you are stuck, right? You are stuck. You're wasting the asset. And of course, you've only got a limited amount of time to actually use the asset before the trends change, and maybe your asset doesn't have any value. So this is a very true principle right here that's on the screen. Now, what I'm going to do is, to help explain it to you is I'm going to explain to you what I call the ladder of leverage, all right? So you'll be somewhere on this ladder, and that may make sense to you at some level, and then you're going to see where you are positioned in it and maybe where you want to go. So I'm going to evaluate this by the earning capacity, by your work demand, and by the characteristics of what it's like to be in that level, okay? Now, the first level on the ladder is where we have no income, all right, where in terms of employment, in terms of cash flow, there's none. You have no income. So there's zero earning dollars in earning capacity. There's 0 hours of work demand because you don't have anything, right? You don't have anything to get paid for. And the characteristics are where you're desperate. Anybody in that no income mode has desperation hanging around them. It's all around them because they are wanting to take any job they can get, any contract they can get, to do whatever they can do to get it. And so it makes a desperation part of their lives because there's no income, so they're not in a strong position, right? So that's why it's the very bottom off the ladder when I talk about leverage over your asset. Above that is the next level up where it's someone like a course creator. And what I mean is where you can go and actually start creating some training right now. You can put it on a site called Udemy, Udemy, and they will sell it for you and you get a commission and all the rest, but it's a very low prices. And what it means is you end up having to work for about $5 to $20 per hour. How does that work? Well, when you're selling stuff at low dollar value, you're selling your knowledge in this instance through courses of how to do this, how to do that, it means you become a commodity. And so that the more hours you put into that project and the less you charge for it means the less you're getting paid per hour. And on top of that, there's also then the maintenance of the program. You've got to put more time into that. And then also the upkeep of the customer service to all those clients. So it's a high volume model. So as you get, you know, you're at least gonna be working 40 hours a week just to be able to do that for all the customers. You know, look after them, reply to their emails, send them their new logins. Oh, you didn't receive that email, I'll message you again. You know, so there's a lot of work there. And so it means that you're dabbling in the world of entrepreneurship, I guess you'd call it, right? But you have low impact because people are paying a low dollar for your course, you know, maybe something like $47. So therefore, you've got a low impact in their life. They may look at your course, they may not, no big deal. They spent $47, they intended to, but didn't get around to it. And therefore, you're not a big influence in their life. But also, you're not really solving much of a problem either. If someone doesn't look at your training, someone doesn't take it seriously, then you truly can't impact them the way you really want to. So course creators are just above no income. And most people actually try and make money online aren't making any money. They might make a sale here or there, but it's not consistent. And I'd put them in that category there as well. Next up from them is where I see employees, all right? An employee where you would work somewhere between, say, $30 and $70 per hour, all right? Maybe a little bit more, maybe a little bit less, you can decide. But it's the next level up, right? So in terms of earning capacity, a little bit better off now, right? More predictability there, which is good, right? But now you're going to be working about 40 to 60 hours, all right? Might vary week to week, but you're now needing to be in the workplace for the employer. They have demands on you. And of course, the higher dollar they pay you per hour, the more they own you, so to speak. The more they own what you're doing, the demands they can put on you, right? As you increase your hourly rate, so do the demands. And so the bottom line is that when you work for somebody else, an employee, you're building someone else's dream. And it's not like it's a bad thing, but it's just you've got to realize where you are in the ladder, right? In that you're building someone else's dream. It was never your dream, it never will be. They will get all the main benefit. You'll get a wage. You'll get some security until they decide that they don't want you on their team and then you don't have security. So it's a fake security. But that's where employees are. And that's like low level and high level management, somewhere in there, right? Maybe a couple of changes in dollars per hour, but very much that similar type of deal. Even if you're in upper management, you're still building someone else's dream, right? So up from employee is what most people tend to think of, well, I'll go out on my own as a consultant. And that way I can charge more per hour. In fact, you'll end up charging between about $70 and $150 on average. And that sounds good. So you've increased your hourly rate, so it feels better. But then you have the problem of actually being able to get employment and get contracts and be able to work for others at that rate. And sometimes it's consistent, sometimes it's not, most often it's not. And you're at least going to be working around about 60 to 80 hours a week. So now we've increased our earning capacity, but our work demand has also increased, right? This is at the maximum of working capacity. When you're a consultant, maximum, because there are tons of hours where you cannot charge for, right? Aren't billable hours. So you find yourself working on weekends, even at night, thinking about the clients, what you, how you can help them, what you're going to tell them. So you put them in a lot of hours that maybe you don't even put down on paper, let alone bill from, you're not even where you're doing them, but it comes with a high price tag in that area. But it means that you're also stressed and vulnerable. On the whole, consultants are stressed and vulnerable. Stressed because they have to keep clients coming in. They have to retain clients, have to keep the clients happy so they stay. They have to do all the accountancy work that required with a consultancy in terms of, you have your own business, you've got all the numbers to make work. You've got tax that's due, insurances, staff, things like that. And you're vulnerable too because when you're a consultant, there's usually a limit to how many clients you can take on. Like, for instance, if you're a consultant and I was to throw 20 clients at your way right now, you would be toast, right? Because you can't handle 20 clients at once, so it's not scalable. So what it means is you've got to keep your clients to a minimum, and that makes you vulnerable because if one or two leave like that, boom, suddenly your income drops dramatically. So there's a lot of vulnerability when you're being a consultant. But yet it's lauded by, in the corporate world, everyone thinks about, becoming a consultant. But I talk to consultants nearly every day, and the stress level's high, the vulnerability feels high, and they just aren't earning the money they thought they would, or they're not getting the respect they thought they would that when they were working for a big corporate, right? Just like for a consultant is where you start and get a bit more leverage in terms of you become a group coach. You think, well, instead of working, one-to-one, I could work with many. I could work one-to-many where you might take on groups of people and teach them, help them, consult to them. And often you get paid up to like $1,000 a day to run a workshop and, a classroom environment sometimes, or just come along and talk to a group of people. Or consult to one or two people. So a group coach is actually not bad. Now it's $1,000 a day, all right? But the issue is it's not every single day. It's very rarely that for every working day of the week, so let's say 5 days a week, it's very rare you actually get a gig where you get a gig every single day at $1,000 a day. When you're getting it, it's great. When it's not, it's like, well, the vulnerabilities become very clear, right? You end up working around about 30 to 40 hours now, so our work demand has gone down. As we move up the ladder from this point on, the work demand goes down because it's a better model. Helping people, coaching them, a group is much smarter than coaching one-to-one. You can help more people. They can all pay you a fee for you to coach them. So your income goes up and it means you have to actually spend less time because you're just working with a group. Right? Now, the characteristic of that is that sometimes you get travel. So you get invited to, work around the country, maybe even work overseas. You run workshops, it's a great way to train groups. So there's that part as well, which is nice. That's a good upside. You're training people at groups at once rather than just one-to-one. So it's actually not too bad a model. Up from there is where you say, well, hold on. I wonder if I could do this, but using the internet with the fantastic power of the internet, I wonder if I could do that, right? And this is where you might be able to charge about $2,000 per client. So the big change here is that you've gone from an hourly rate, a daily rate, and then into a client rate. So $2,000 per client. So maybe people are buying access to your training in any topic, and there's some modules for them to go through. Now you're working around about 20 to 30 hours a week, so that's better. That's definitely better. But it requires volume. If you're to earn a really good income, you'd need at least 100 clients at $2,000, which is $200,000, so that's great. But you have taxes to take out of that, all your costs out of that, and a few other things as well. So you need volume. And often the way that's done is where you run live webinars. You run live webinars to bring clients in, and you use live webinars to keep clients on board. So a lot of live work where it's usually at night. Webinars are done at night, so it eats into your private life. So it's a little bit of a downside there, but it's a good model. It's like the best model yet as we go up the ladder, I'm sure you can agree. Up from there is where you become a high-ticket online group coach, okay? And the wording that is very specific, high ticket online group coach. So it's a better version because now we're able to charge about $3,000 to $10,000 per client. Right now, getting into a really good income where it doesn't take a lot of clients to be enrolled in your system for you to make a really good income because now we're at a really good price. Okay, you'll end up working around about 10 or 15 hours a week. Now it's getting much better, right? Your work demand is much less. 10 to 15 hours a week, brilliant, right? Now you have a lifestyle and you have the income. And the characteristic of that is that generally that means that you're going to scale things up. So You can handle 10 clients. Of course you could. You can handle 100. You can handle 300, 400, 500 because it's all online. It's high ticket. And there's a model that goes with that where there's scalability in the model. All right. And the automation part is where the marketing can be automated, where people go through automated webinars in order to become clients. A lot of the training itself is all delivered on automation. So it's a very, very attractive model. Income's great, the work demand's awesome, and then the fact that it's scalable, you know, to whatever really, and automated, that's even better as well. So it's very, very strong. Top of the tree, there's still one more, right? And it's called where you're an authority or a thought leader. Where you've really taken charge of your niche and you've taken your knowledge, your asset, your skills, your asset, and your knowledge, your experience and skills, pardon me, which build your asset, and you've used it to the nth degree. Where your earning capacity now is like between $10,000 and $25,000 and plus, right, and up. So you have that that position in the market where you are an authority in it, right? So now you can charge much higher prices. So the income's awesome. The work demand's even better where it's 5 to 10 hours a week. And you might just do a talk here, a talk there, and you're done. And the whole system's set up where all your delivery of your program, your knowledge, your asset, your skills are all done. It's all done automatically through a website, released automatically. Everyone's tracked. And you're just really speaking. You might hold a webinar every now and then, but you're very specialized at what you do and you're very good at it. And the characteristics are that you do a little bit of maybe online speaking, but also mainly speaking in person. And you get to enjoy that speaker's lifestyle, which is absolutely fantastic. Maybe travel the world, at least travel the country. High respect from people who know you and see you. Lots of perks. So it really is an awesome model. Okay. Now, that is the ladder of leverage. I'm sure now you can work out and see where you are on that and maybe where you want to go. So now it puts it in an order, right, of how that all works. Now, if you're in this section here that I'm putting in bracket, that's where you're selling your time. By and large, if you're in those categories there, you're selling your time. Now, time is never a great option. It's an okay option. It's never a great option. It gets you to survival, all right? So you can survive on it. The higher you go in that little section there, but you're still selling your time, which makes you a little bit vulnerable. Right? The upper bit there that I've just put a bracket around, that's where you're selling results. And this is where you want to go because it gives you so much more. The bottom section is really, it holds you captive. You're held captive to the job, to contract, you know, to that model. You have to be on the ground. You have to be close to it. Requires more attention, whereas the upper section here is where the freedom's at, where things are automated. You can scale up without freaking out. You can choose who you work with. So it's all about freedom, right? So much better. The ones at the top there, the benefits of those is freedom as opposed to being captive down below where there's so many restrictions on you, okay? So when you look at this table, where do you want to head to? If you've got any sort of clue about, you know, using your time wisely, then it's obviously going to be in the top two section that I've highlighted. Those are your two to aim for, where you're getting, you know, good income, lower hours, and a lot of automation and scale and speaking is a great way to market yourself and your business. So that's where you want to aim for in terms of leverage. So if I was looking at this list and I'm you, I'm thinking, okay, where do I fit in? And you may not have even have thought that maybe you had something of worth to fit into this ladder, right? But in fact, you do, because remember your asset, which is your knowledge, your experience, your skills. These three things is what allows you to have something unique, which you then can sell to the masses, right? This is how you make money from what you know, right? You can sell what you know. So if you are a business owner and you're really good at running a restaurant, the restaurant's your current business, but really what you could do is you could add another income of where you're actually teaching people how to have a great restaurant. You put into your online group course all the fundamentals of how you do this, how you do that, and this becomes an income which could quite possibly take over your restaurant's income because the work demand's low, it's very, very appealing, high ticket price. So don't underestimate yourself. If you have knowledge and experience and skills that other people could benefit from, where you could help them, you know, you're an answer to a problem, then moving towards the top of this ladder is where you want to go. And it is just so possible, you know, once you know how. Problem is, not many people know how. Not many people know how to take their asset, their knowledge, their experience and skills. Not many people know how to take that and then turn it into a gold mine, right? How to actually mine that asset, how to leverage that asset. Now, if you don't know how to do it, but you really want to, then would you like me to give you a plan to take what you know and turn it into a very profitable business? Would you like me to help you with that? I can show you how to create it and how to sell it so it really works. Now, the thing is, only if you're serious, all right? If you're serious about what I just said and it really sort of rings a bell with you, I'm happy to help you develop a plan for free, all right? Completely for free, no obligation whatsoever, to help you attract the right clients for the idea or for your business, productize your business, which means take your knowledge, experience, skills, and turn that into a product, right? Product which you can sell, you know, probably via an online course. And that, once you productize something, then it allows you freedom from the asset, right? Rather than selling your time. And then lastly, give you a plan and show you how to work less than 15 hours a week. All right? Would that be good? If you want to know how to do that, then it starts with a call with me, and there is zero obligation, because what I do is I use this call to find out more about you. I mean, you being part of my group and watching videos like this, you start to know me. I don't know you yet. So it's a way for me to actually talk to you, find out more about you, and help you on the phone. So I will do that, guaranteed. And then maybe, should we work together? Who knows? I'm not even offering that yet. But if you were to be a good fit and you agree that I was a good fit for you, then I can help you do that. But one thing I never do is I never allow anyone to come and be coached by me if we're not the right fit. That's not how I run my business, all right? So I'm going to help you first, and then maybe we see if we're a fit. Who knows? But it'll always be your choice and my choice about where we go from there. But I'm actually available to help you out. It'll be a 45-minute call. Here's where to go. You go to brettmcfall.com/session, all right? So you go and open up a new tab in your internet software. Type in brettmcfall.com/session, and that allows you to book a time with me. And look, if I think you've got a shot at this, I will tell you exactly how to do it. I'll personalize it all for you. And I'll show you why it worked, why it will work. I'll tell you everything about it. And if you're not if you're not in the right zone right now for that, then I will tell you that as well. All right. So that's the thing, that I will tell you exactly where you are. I have no vested interest. I have no hidden agenda. I'll tell you exactly where you are, where you can take it. And that might be yes or it might be no, but I'll at least let you know where you're at. Right? So that's the website there to book in for a call with me. And if not, then I wish you all the best, of course, and let me know if you have any challenges in the future on this page where you can let me know all about anything you want to know to do with, you know, taking that asset and doing something with it and leveraging that asset. All right, so I hope that it helped you out. I'm Brett McFall, and that's my little live lesson here on Billion Dollar Experts right now. Okay. And I look forward to hopefully talking to you soon on the call.